Welcome to Mail Monday, a weekly series that's not so much about the gameplay, but instead is about your questions and my answers to them. I know you love the gameplay, but I just pick it based on how long it is, really. I try to get something that is the right length for Mail Monday. Let's get started. Hey, Woody. Not sure if you'll ever read this, but I felt like the message was necessary. I asked my now girlfriend out. The advice you gave me and thousands of others really meant something to me. You told me just to go for it and seize the opportunity. So I did, and it worked out for me, man. And you were the person to thank. Keep at it. And then I cut off his name, because even happy stuff like this, I like it anonymous. I don't want you guys to get any negative repercussions from the show. But yeah, so I had done this letter saying, like, you know, do not ask somebody out because you're scared. Do not, you know, fail to see something that you really want because, you know, you're afraid that you'll be judged or something like that. And here's a guy who asked out this girl and she said yes. And now he has a girlfriend and now he's happy. And where would he have been if he had let his fear get the best of him? That's why I picked this. I wanted you guys to see like a little success story here. And I often get asked, hey, Woody, you know, why don't you do follow-up letters with everybody? And the reason that I don't is that, well, one, a lot of times it would take like a seriously long follow-up, you know, 9 months later to see how his relationship with his father has changed or improved or whatever. And then the other part of it is, you know, like I can't just do all the work, right? Like when I answer your questions, I can just depend on me and make sure that it gets done. When I'm relying on you to reply to me about your questions, then that's harder to do. Having said that, if I pick one of your letters and you want to do a follow-up, then I'm really interested in how the advice worked out for you. But let's move on to the next one. How do I get fighting courage? Dear Woody, I'm 19. I cannot seem to build courage when this situation occurs. Last night, I was coming home with four of my friends at 2 a.m. We stopped at McDonald's to grab a bite, and we saw two younger punks littering. So as a joke, we said, hey, don't litter. They approached our truck ready to fight the four of us and threatening us. We drove away in shame after a 10-minute argument. I felt less of a man ever since. The same thing happened a month ago at a bar when three guys got kicked out. They came toward five of my friends and we outnumbered them, and we still turned away in shame. How do I build confidence as a man? How am I ever going to protect a woman if I can't build the courage to get out of the car with my four friends behind me? Please help. I can't face myself in the mirror. All right, so the first thing in this letter that strikes me is whether or not this is a fighting situation at all, right? And let me just address this freaking YouTube drama I had a month ago. A lot of guys have that story wrong, right? They have this notion that I called out this guy to fight. That's not what actually happened. He called out me. He said, Woody, I want to fight you at PAX. I said, yes. Same thing I tell everybody. And then he said, no, Woody, I changed my mind. I don't want to fight you at PAX. And I said, okay, I'm not going to chase you around and bully you. That's how that went down. Don't get the story twisted into thinking that I called him out. That's not how it went. I thought, you know, if I were to do that again, I'd do the same damn thing. You call me out, I say yes. You run away in fear, I say, okay, I'm not going to chase you. That to me seemed like a pretty good way to handle it. But back on topic, this guy, he's in a situation where he has pretty much things not worth fighting about. You know, some guy was littering and he, you know, he or a friend said something. And what this fight is really about is some sort of bullshit show of machismo, right? You know, to figure out who's the manlier man. And for, you know, like that by itself, it doesn't seem worth risking a street fight. You know, really horrible things could happen in this. Really, you know, there could be serious consequences to getting into a street fight. Having said that, there's serious emotional consequences to not getting in one, too. And that's where he is now. He's like, look, you know, it seems like twice in the last month or so, I've had these situations where I shouldn't be the one, you know, hopping in my car and driving away in shame where we all silently look and know that we made our decision based on being scared. And that's the core of it, right? So sometimes, and I'm going to kick back to the Karate Kid here. Sometimes, if you don't know the Karate Kid, here it is in a nutshell. The guy gets picked on by a bunch of people that know karate. He learned karate. He went to a tournament. At this tournament, they cheated and they injured him even though he was doing really well because they were scared. And then, you know, he talks to his sensei and he says, look, heal me, heal me. He has these ancient Eastern healing techniques. And the guy says, no, you've proved your point. You're fantastic. And he's like, prove my point. No, I haven't proved my point. I'm still not centered with myself. I still feel like I am their victim. And the guy's like, all right, that's a legit reason to keep going in this competition. And he heals him and then he goes and it goes out great. That's where this guy is, right? It's not so much that he's fighting about the stupid litter. It's not so much that he's fighting about some stupid thing where, you know, some guy made a comment. He's fighting because he doesn't feel comfortable with himself making decisions out of fright. That's the core of it. And is that a good reason to fight? Is it a good reason to fight because you feel better looking at yourself in the mirror if you had a black eye than if you ran away? It might be. It might be. Because this stuff can haunt you, right? This stuff can build up and you know, these opportunities don't happen all the time. So they can linger. And there it is. So let's go to the core of the letter. Woody, how do I be brave? And, my answer to this, in small increments. You know, when you need to do things that require some sort of bravery, it's typically not an all-day activity. You know, it's not like you need to be brave all the time. You just need to be brave for 20 seconds. Give yourself 20 seconds of bravery when you need it. Allow it, demand it, expect it. That's what you need. You know, if it's a fight situation, things only going to last a couple minutes, but the initiation is only going to last a couple of seconds. You know, the next time you need 20 seconds of bravery, go ahead and expect that from yourself and make it so. If you're cliff diving, it takes 1 second. If you're asking out a girl, it takes 15 seconds of, all right, I'm going to walk over to her. I'm going to say hello and introduce myself and see where it goes from there. That's how much bravery you need to make something happen. And if it's a fight, if it's a social situation, if it's element of danger where you think you should, I don't know, rescue a dog or a child or whatever it is you're doing, bravery doesn't happen all day long. Bravery happens when you first start, when you first initiate this thing. Maybe it's the big game at your high school football team or something. That's when you need that. And you don't need it all day long. You just need to demand it of yourself for 15 seconds and then go and do what you know how to do. So, how do I get fighting courage? 10, 15 seconds at a time, just tell yourself, like, look, I'm going to suck it up. I'm going to do this. Even if it's like this out of body experience, make it happen. And then you are what other people think is brave, even though in your head, you knew you were, second guessing yourself the entire time your actions were brave. That's what it's really like. So I wish you the best of luck, and I encourage you to cut yourself a little bit of slack for this thing, right? These guys are jackasses, who knows what they were on. Put the past in the past. You're a good guy. Hey, Woody, me and my girlfriend both think we're ready for sex. We're 14. Before you say too young, listen, we've been dating for 6 months. Long, I know, and we're very much in love. You're probably saying, dude, you're 14, you don't know what love is. But no, I do know what it is. I'd do anything for her. I'd take a bullet for her, and she'd do the same for me. That being said, would it be okay to have sex at 14? Safely, of course. Would getting condoms for my parents be a good idea? Sorry for all the questions, I have a lot. Would telling my parents I'm having sex be a good idea, or should I keep it a secret? Thanks for the help. Maybe you can use this for Mail Monday. Big fan. 14's pretty young, dude. It's not that you don't know what love is. I think at 14 or 15, I did. I had some pretty strong feelings. It's not that you're not physically ready. I mean, heck, if you were, Native American Indians 300 years ago, then you guys would be married off at 14 years old. But in today's society, here's the deal. Like, every time you have sex with someone, right, you give that person a little piece of yourself, right? It's part of your permanent record. And if you do it too cheaply, then you don't have anything left. If you have sex, with me, not that you're interested because you're a 14-year-old boy and it's not my style either, but, that would be like a major commitment, right? That would be something. That's not something that just gets shared freely and rolls anywhere. It's important. It's notable. It's not something that you just toss away as if it had no value. Now, you say you like her and you like her a lot, but 6 months doesn't strike me as a very long time. It seems like to me like you guys could wait. And, if you find yourself not dating at 9 months, then you'll be really happy that, you're still available for somebody else. You're off to a pretty early start. I would say no. I would say hang on. 6 months is not a long dating period in my mind. and you don't want to give yourself away too freely. If you liked today's video, be sure to click on that like button. If you're new around here and you like the video, you can click on subscribe in the top right. Two vids you may have missed. The top one is F. Kyle. And there was some confusion about our relationship and stuff, and I kind of laid it out there. I also kind of hope Kyle never sees it, but it is what it is. And the bottom one is about changes that are coming soon, according to Infinity Ward, about Modern Warfare 3. And some exciting stuff. I'm happy about what's coming in there, and I explain it all in the video. So I hope you guys liked it, and have a good day.